I am J. Ranganayagi, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science. Now discuss the topic as vector processor. What is the vector processor? The multiple processing elements that perform the same operations on multiple data points simultaneously. So multiple instructions and multiple data can be executed for single time, that is single at a time. Is called a vector processor. This vector processor is basically central processing unit. All the instructions can be based on your central processing unit. So that central processing unit that has to be able to execute the complete vector input in a single instruction. That is, multiple data can be executed for single time, that is single instruction, called a vector processor. So next one is more specialist for vector processors. So why you are more specialist for vector processors? It is a complete unit of hardware resources that execute for sequential order. That is, sequential order can be execute the instructions. Also, set of similar data items in the memory using the single instructions. All the instructions, all the data items can be executed for single instructions. This vector processor, it also acts the SIMD. So what is the SIMD? That is single instructions and multiple data streams. So what is the SIMD? This SIMD, multiple processing element that can be performed for single instruction, is called a SISD. So this vector processor also execute the MIMD. So what is the MIMD? So multiple instructions and multiple data streams. So multiple data can be executed for multiple data streams. That is one of the vector processor. So next one is this vector processor elements or all the elements can be ordered for properly, that is simultaneously. So they have to successive addressing format of the memory. So this is a vector processor reason. So we have mentioned before implemented data sequencing. What is the implement of data sequencing? All the data can be sending for through scalar processor and vector processor. So next one is this vector processor holds the address of the single control unit. That is, as a multiple executions that perform the same operations of different data elements of the vector processor. So multiple instructions unit can be executed for same operations also single at the time. That is a vector processor. So this is for likely for the vector processor. So next one is a scalar processor. What is the scalar processor? This scalar processor operates only one data, that is only single pair of data executed for at a time. So more instructions cannot be executed for single time. That is the scalar processor. This is the most of the multiprocessor cannot be used for scalar processor. But vector processor acts the multiple pair of data executed for single instructions. So how to work for a scalar to vector processor? So once you convert a scalar code into vector code, so all the instructions, scalar instructions, you convert the vector instructions. So this type of conversions process is called a vector sessionization. So what this type of vector process allows all the operations on the multiple data elements by the help of single instruction, that is a method of SIST. So next one is this type of vector processor instructions are said to be single instructions, multiple data, or vector instructions. So all the CPU, that is processing unit, reason time of makes the use of vector processors. For main advantages of a scalar processing and vector processing. So next one is the architecture of vector processor. So more than 4 and 5 function units of the vector processing, that is architecture. So first one is the main memory. Second one is the IPU, that is a instructions processing unit. So next one is the scalar register, then pipelining. Next one is a vector access controller, then vector instructions controller, then vector register, then pipeline. So first, what is the main memory? So what is the main memory? That main memory transfer to the all the data to supply to the scalar processor or vector processor. So what is the IPU, that is instructions processing units? So this type of instruction processing to transfer the data to scalar register or vector register. So next one is here, scalar register. What is the scalar register? The process is only one items at the time, with type of a data items being the integer or floating. So what is the integer? So integer means is a round up number. So floating, it is a decimal number. So this type of scalar register or scalar process is classified the SASD, that is single instruction, single data stream. So only one instructions can be executed for single time, that is a scalar register. So next one is a vector register. So what is the vector register? This vector register stores the several data elements at a time. So several data items can be stored in at a time, which is called a vector operand. So this vector operand has several scalar elements. This type of vector instructions need to perform the same operation on the different data set. It's called a vector register. So next one is a scalar processor. So only one processes can be executed at the time. So next one is a functionals. Next is a functions of vector processor. So as it is a several functions pipes that can be executed for instructions over the operands. So first, what is first? Once the instruction fetched, then the IPU, that is the instructions processing unit. So once the instruction is fetched, then IPU determine either the fetched instruction is scalar or vector processor. So fetch the instructions to transfer the scalar register or vector instructions controller. If it is scalar processing nature means, then instruction is transferred to the scalar register. And the further scalar processing is performed. So then will be the instruction is vector in the natures, then it is fetched to the vector instructions controller. This vector instructions controller first decode the vector instruction, then accordingly they determine the address of the vector operand present in the memory. So that is a give a signal to the vector access controller. So once getting the data from the IPU means, this vector instructions controller to go to the vector access controller. This vector access controller about the so demand of the respective operands. So this vector access controller then fetch the desired the operands from the main memory. So one fetch the data from the main memory. So next, once the operands is fetched, then they provide the instruction to the vector register. So that is can be processed at the vector processor. So vector processes can be executed for the pipelining concept. What is the pipelining concept? So what is the pipelining? So pipelining concept is a single instructions can be executed for multiple data, multiple elements can be executed for single time, that is at the time, that is a pipelining concept. So this type of vector register, so how many data and how many elements can be stored for in vector register? So this vector register, it hold the 64 elements or data and 64 bits of the vector. So next is a vector register. So this type of vector register can be files reads of 16 ports. So reading file is 16 port and write port is 8 bit, that is a vector register. So next one is a scalar processor. So it is acts the scalar processes 32-bit general purpose register and 32-bit is a floating point register, that is a first 32 bit is acts the general processing unit. So remaining 32 bit it acts the 32 bit register, that is called a vector processor. So next is a function. These are all functions units can be discussed for vector processors. All the elements can be executed for functions of vector processor. So how will we execute the vector processor? So there are two types of base addresses of a vector processor. So how will we execute? So first is C equal to A plus B. Just I doing the add functions. Just A plus B add the can be stored for C. So 1 is 100 is a vector length. Okay. So A is a variable, B is a variable, C is a variable. So 1 is 100 is a vector length. So first is a opcode. So what is the operation code? That is a specification of operation, that is a addition operation. So next one is a base address. What is the base address? That is a base address source. One is a variable. So next one, base address source two can be used for B variable. Next base address of destination is a C. So base water source plus base address source two can be both added, source one added, source one plus source two. It can be stored for destination address. So two elements can be added and then store the C, that is destination part. So last one is specify the vector length. So all the variables it is equalized for same vector length, that is a 1 is 100. So next one is a comparison of scalar processor and vector processor. What is the scalar processor and vector processor? So scalar processor acts the only one operation for at the time, but a vector processor it executes the n number of elements at the single time. So see the diagram. So first one is a scalar operations, that is I need the addition operations. So I take the three type of register, so R3, R1 and R2. So R1 add to R3, then store the result of R3. So only one operations doing the single time, that is a scalar processor. But here see the vector processor. So too many vector processor in executing the elements. So for example, add, so add dot VB V3 comma V1 comma V2. So here, so V1 is a multiple memory spaces. So V2 is a multiple memory spaces. Also V3 is a multiple part for vector length. So but here what is scalar processes, only one length can be specified. But here what is so many length? Okay, so vector processes more than 100 or no limitation of your length. So many data, so many elements can be stored for vector processor. So V1 adding V2 then stored to V3. So many operations, that is so many multiple data can be added for stored in V3. That is a vector processor. That is most of the like the vector processing operations. That is a vector processor. For example, this is for previous slides, compare the hardware operation, that is hardware diagram of a scalar processor and vector processor. So now it executes the programming language. How will we execute the scalar processor and vector processor? How will we execute the programming language? I take some three variables of adding processor. First one is the scalar processor. So this is I take the loop of 10 iterations. I take the 10 elements for adding purpose. So five, I take the scalar. That is A comma B. So read I comma instructions and decode the elements. Next one is a fetch the A element and fetch the B element, add A plus B, then will do. So first initially I take the first step. So I equal 0 means you fetch B. So add A plus B, then store the result. So next increment the I value. So I equal to 2 means again to fetch the two elements at the result of seed store. So again increment the I equal to 3 means again fetch the two elements, add and store the result of seed. So again increment the I equal to 4. So again you fetch the two elements, they add the result and store the result. So up to I equal to 0 to I to 10. That is a 10 iterations can be executed for every time. That is a scalar processes. Each and every time increment the loop, and then every time you fetch the elements and execute the looping. That is a scalar process or general processing. But here, what is the vector processing? So read the instruction and decode. Fetch the all the 10 elements at the time. Okay, the fetch the all the 10 elements of A variable and fetch the all the 10 elements of B variable, then adding A plus B to store the result of C. So only one iterations can be executed and only one loop executed for vector processing at the time. So only one time executed for 10 iterations at a time, or no limitations of your looping statements. So it is a vector processing. So most likely for vector processing, it can be used for so many real-time applications. That is a vector processor compared to scalar processor. So next one is a classification of vector processor. There are two types of classification in vector processor. One is a register to register. Second one is a memory to memory architecture. So what is the memory to memory architectures? This type of memory to memory operate, that is architecture, this type of vector processor, the operands for the instruction, the intermediate result and the, that is a memory to memory. So all the vector processor, that the operands for the instructions, intermediate result and the final result, all this are retrieved or read from the main memory. So all the data, all the operands and results can be fetched from the memory within the directly using the register. That is a memory to memory architectures. It noted here the address of the desired data accessed by present in the vector instructions. So all the data, all the elements to fetch the directly from the main memory is called a memory to memory architecture. So this type of architecture fetching the data sizes 512 bits from the main memory to pipeline. So these are all high memory access time. So compared to register architectures, so memory access time is very high. This memory to memory architecture, it has the pipelining concept. What is the pipeline? So multiple data, multiple elements is executed for at the same time. That is a pipelining concept. So this type of pipelining of the vector computer, it require the higher startup time. That is a higher time of required the initiated of vector instruction. So many examples available in memory to memory architecture. So what are the real-time examples for memory-to-memory architecture? So it is used for Splatter supercomputer, Cyber 205, CDC, compact disk of comparison. So many real-time examples available for memory-to-memory architecture. So next one is a register-to-register architecture. So this type of architectures to fetching the operands or elements indirectly the vector processor or scalar processor. So, but the memory is to fetch the operands directly main memory, but register architecture is to fetch the operands or data is either a scalar processor or vector processor. It's called a register to register architecture. This type of register help to the vector computer to retrieve, that is retrieve or read the data from the vector register or scalar register, and also storing the result in the desired register. But memory is stored the main memory. But here, what are the operands store the desired register. What is the desired register? That is the scalar or vector register. So this type of vector register are uses the instructions programmable. It is called a register to register architecture. For examples, using the register to register architecture is used for supercomputer using the register to register architecture or PRISC 1, so etc. So many registers can be used for this type of architecture. So next one is advantages of architecture. What are the advantages? So this type of vector processor. So what are the advantages? Vector processor uses the vector instruction by which store density of the instructions can be improved. So what is the density? All the instructions, all the elements can be executed for fastly compared to scalar processing. So second point is each and every result is independent. So independent of previous result, allowing the deep pipelines and the high clock rates. The third point is the sequence arrangements of data help to handle the data by the whoever is better way. All the other components on the program will handle these smoothly better view of vector processing. So next one is to reduce the bandwidth of your instructions or operands, that is a vector processor. So next one is to increase the code density. So what is the code density? See, normal scalar processes act the, that is the seven lines of coding processing. But here what vector processing code is just a 10 for 5 lines. So that is a better to scalar process. So only execute the 5 lines of code. That is to reduce the lines code, then increase the density of programmable coding. So next one is decrease the total number of instructions. So your instruction list can be reduced for vector processing. So next one is vector instructions can be accessed with the patterns. That is that's the pattern format, which is allow the multiple memory banks and simultaneously to supply the operands. This is for main point of your vector processing. To access the memory known as the pattern format, which is allow the multiple memory banks to simultaneously to supply the operands to pipelining or scalar processing. So next one is data is organized as a pattern method. So last one is scalable. So it is the vector processor instruction is very high level scalable. So next one is disadvantages of vector processor. What are the disadvantages? This type of architectures is hardware components very high cost than expensive compared to scalar processor. So next one is it add the extra functional unit, that is a vector functional unit and then register. But scalar processor, it is used for only one register, that is a scalar register. By compared to vector processor, it adding the extra one component, that is a vector instructions controller. So next one is the modification of memory system. This type of memory system is modified is difficult to compare to other processor, because the memory system is a very difficult is designed of vector processor. So next one is the applications of vector processor. One is a server, so next one is a home cinema, third one is a super computing, next cluster computing, then mainframe. So so many applications are can be used for vector processor. The example, this type of vector processor can be used for mathematical calculation, that is a linear algebra, this image processing, and then audio synthesis, compression, photography, speech recognition. So this vector processor can be used for cine field also. So what is the uses of cine field? That is image processing, audios, and then to edit the videos and then audios and the speech recognition. These are all type of the real-time applications. So, and also it adds the supercomputing and cluster computing. That is, what is the supercomputing? That is a register to register architectures. So many real-time applications can be used for, that is, vector processor. and then nowadays is discussed the vector process also used for Flint's classification. So what is the Flint's classification? So many types of Flint's classification applications can be used for vector processor. So I discussed the two applications for in Flint's classification. So first one is SISD, SIMD, MIMD, MISD. So these are all real applications of using for vector processor. So thank you.